Steelers, talk about an unforgettable arrival today. Steeler Brett Kiesel driving up to training camp at St. Vincent College in a huge bulldozer.
That's the way to unload your luggage. He's not the only one making a grand entrance. Action Sports' Justin Rose with the annual Black and Gold Pilgrimage to Latrobe.
Move-in day has come and gone. The Steelers all settled at their new home right here at St. Vincent College in Latrobe as training camp gets underway. The guys, they're wrapping up right now their run test to see just how in shape they are after their off-season conditioning. They all got moved in today. Take a look at some of the stuff they brought with them. That's an Xbox. I don't know how much time they'll have to play that game machine, but they brought a bunch of pillows, extra blankets, all of their clothes. This is now home. And they're excited about what the 2013 spring training campaign will be.
It's real exciting, pulling up, seeing how good the fields look, and just being a part of this, and you know, coming to St. Vincent's, and knowing as a kid growing up, this is where the Steelers hold training camp. So it's pretty exciting to be here and ready to get to work.
I'm very excited, you know, get to see all the work I put forward, and you know, see the young guys and see how they respond, and you know, see what the old dogs have learned too.
Now, coming up at the 6 o'clock hour, we'll tell you the results from that run test, which guys maybe exceeded expectation, which guys did really well, and well, which guys should have got off the couch a little bit more during the summertime. With the Steelers in Latrobe, Justin Rose, Channel 4 Action Sports.
The run test is an awful lot of fun. It dates back to 1998. Jermaine Stevens, top pick that year, didn't finish the test.
Ooh.
And thus, now it is something to watch to see who's in shape and who's not.
I love it. Hey, you know, we have the full training camp schedule online at WTAE.com. Just click on the Steelers tab at the very top of our homepage.
And of course, we want to see your Steeler fan photos from Latrobe when you show up tomorrow. Upload them to our U-Local section either through WTAE.com or by using our WTAE smartphone app.
All right, the big question, is the weather going to hold up for fans going out to camp?
Well, WeatherWatch 4 Chief Meteorologist Mike Harvey has the answer for Steeler Nation.
Speaking of people who could get off the couch a little bit more this summer, you're right.
There
yeah.
you go.
If you're heading out there tomorrow, definitely going to want to take the rain jacket with you. Not going to be a complete washout, but there is going to be a chance for rain. Let's show you what's happening right now. We have a cold front which is getting ready to move into the area. High pressure has been with us for the last couple of days, and it has been glorious weather, but that cold front is poised to move in. Now, the cold front doesn't arrive until we get very late Saturday night into Sunday morning, and this is what it looks like. The rain's going to start to move in by about noon tomorrow. We can see some scattered showers moving our way, but really the heavier stuff probably not going to move until we go from Saturday night into Sunday morning. So really for training camp, we are looking at a chance of some scattered showers moving in. Temperature of 75 degrees. They're going to do the practice about 255. You'll definitely want to have a light rain jacket in the car just in case you have some rain showers to find you out there in Latrobe. Guys?